This incredible flashlight is the best way to turn night into day. With close to 100,000 lumens of output, a huge battery pack, and an advanced cooling system. It's expensive, yes, but the Acebeam X75 is extremely well designed and offers excellent value. It's not perfect, but not only is it absurdly bright, one of the brightest flashlights in the world, but it's actually a practical option for someone who just needs tons of light in a portable package. The X75 is insanely powerful, and at its peak output, I measured 74,000 lumens. This is even brighter than many fixed stadium lights, and it's just incredible to hold and use at night. Now, that's a bit less than the claimed 80K lumens, but my testing rig isn't really set up for this insane level of output, so it's within margin of error. Of course, it's important to note that maximum output cannot be sustained for an extended period of time, as the light gets extremely hot. On turbo, the X75 starts at 40,000 lumens and quickly ramps up to the full amount, and then smoothly drops over the course of 1 minute down to 60K. From there, it quickly drops down to a bit under 20,000 lumens, which is then sustained for another 20 minutes. Meanwhile, the high mode starts at 20K and gradually slopes down over the 25 minute run, and the mid 2 level sustains 9,000 lumens for a full hour. These outputs are extremely impressive, and the advanced high efficiency boost driver allows for solid run times at all levels, even if they are rather short on the highest modes. At about 20,000 lumens, the X75 has the highest sustained output of any flashlight on the market, even beating out the monstrous Immolent MS18, the supposed brightest in the world. Of course, with that much output, even the highly efficient driver and LEDs are still going to produce a ton of heat. And to deal with this, Acebeam has designed a very effective active cooling system for this light. The head of the X75 is very unique, with the block containing the hot LEDs physically separated from the rest of the body with an air gap. A large central fan sucks air from the lower ducts and blows it through a solid copper heatsink and out the vents in the sides of the head. This effectively cools the light and contains the heat in the head, isolated from the user with a large and comfortable carrying handle, to which is attached a central cooling fan. The handle can even be removed to service the fan, with an extra replacement included in the box. Another interesting addition is the rubber cover around the bezel of the light. This helps prevent contact with the super hot metal surrounding the LEDs and provides some extra shock protection for the light itself. It slightly changes colors as it heats up, but it's subtle and you wouldn't see it in the dark anyways. But it is neat. You can remove this cover, which would improve cooling a bit, but I don't really recommend that as the light does get extremely hot and could easily burn your hand. The fan runs automatically at a variable speed as the light reaches a certain temperature. This is the ideal implementation of fan cooling, and I am very happy to see it executed so well here. The fan itself is definitely noticeable, but it's not too loud or annoying, and in my usage, it only got hot enough to run while on turbo, so it's not at all an annoyance in use for me. The light is powered by a removable battery pack, sealed inside which are 4 Hydrain 21700 cells. Underneath a threaded and O-ring sealed cap is a USB-C port which supports power delivery and 100 watt fast charging that fills this pack in about an hour. Between the super high sustained output and rapid charging, getting a second battery pack to swap out would allow for a basically continuous 9000 lumens of output, which is pretty awesome. My only complaint here is the fact that the port is found in a flattened portion of the threads, which reduces bulk a bit, but can cause it to get filled with gunk more easily. The UI is simple and works well. The lower button on the handle turns the light on and off with a single press. Pressing and holding while on ramps up through the main modes, and double pressing activates turbo. Holding from off activates the hidden lowest mode. My only complaint with the interface is the upper button, which has only 2 functions that are both kind of useless. Pressing 10 times will switch between the normal and eco mode groups, but in my tests, there was no difference whatsoever between the two. This button can also be used to turn the fan off completely, which I recommend against. For some odd reason, this auxiliary button is larger than the actual useful button, which kinda sucks. It feels like a wasted feature. Below the buttons is a very cool sliding lock that physically blocks the buttons from being pressed, and can lock the light while on or off, which is a very useful safety feature. The battery pack can also be unscrewed slightly to cut connection. The X75 is a super floody area light that produces basically the same beam as the Immolent MS12 Mini I recently reviewed, but the hotspot is sharper and throws further. Honestly, I prefer the Immolent's beam with its softer hotspot, as the throw on these lights isn't super meaningful anyway due to the insane backwash and blindingly bright foreground object caused by these floody beams. This should really just be looked at as a huge area light. This particular version is a super cool white 6500K color, but the light is also available in a more pleasant neutral tint. I didn't notice any major tint shift. Overall, this is a fantastic high-power flashlight, and while it's overkill for any normal human, I am very happy to recommend this for all your ultra-high power needs. Literally, my only complaint is the inclusion of the useless auxiliary button, and the fact that the USB port is within the threads of the battery pack. Other than that, this light is just brilliantly designed and super high quality. It offers incredible performance at a very reasonable price tag that just wipes the floor with the competition. Seriously, I can't recommend the X75 enough. If you want it and can't afford it, just go for it. This X75 was sent to me free of charge for this video by fellow reviewer Kyle here on YouTube, who started his own flashlight store called GOODNITEGEAR Shop. I don't have any affiliate partnership with him, but he has given me a coupon code you can use to save 10% on items carried at his store, so definitely take advantage of that and support GOODNITEGEAR if you're interested. I really appreciate the support from him in sending me this expensive flashlight. Now, Acebeam only offers this light with XHP 70.2 or 70.3 high-intensity LEDs, which are great, but I do hope to see them provide a high CRI option with the GT FC40 emitters. Acebeam has used this before on the smaller but still super powerful X50, as well as the pocket-sized E70 flashlight, which I've reviewed here on this channel, so go check that out if you're interested. You can also check out this video about the Imolin MS12 Mini, another extremely powerful super flashlight that's much smaller than the X75. We'll be right back.